At the core of the unit was an ex-New South Wales policeman, especially picked to task. This squad was then unleashed upon community forest protesters from the offways to East Gippsland. Its violent tactics only managed to inflame conflict and raise public ire.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
The political tide was turning against the forest managers. 2 weeks after the government's embarrassing timber cutbacks, Rutherford ordered the loggers back into the Goulburn Valley. The operation had been planned by the new enforcement unit and was called Operation Medieval. It appears that Rutherford's decision was a payback to the timber industry for accepting the government logging cutbacks without forcing public criticism and as a direct answer to demands from both the timber industry and logging union officials that Goolaloo must be logged. However, what happened was, and very interestingly, apart from the fact that there was lots of violence targeted at the protesters, that valley actually, through overwhelming majority, was handed back and turned into a national park. Victoria Environmental Assessment Council recommended inclusion of the valley into the adjoining Erinunda National Park, because it was a very, very small amount of land and its insignificance to the timber industry, it seems reasonable to assume the valley will eventually be protected. Through documents released under the Freedom of Information Act, Rutherford's adventure in Goolaloo was later exposed to be a very expensive exercise. The government spent $1.7 million in the Department of Natural Resources and Environment and police law enforcement costs, but the total value of all the timber logged during the operation only amounted to $85,000. So there's some history for you, Mr. Rutherford, I'm sure you're aware of it.